Any of you read the latest Rolling Stone? I was on the phone for a long time last night. And a friend of mine was telling me how, shut the fuck up. Oh, Axel, cool metal dude, rock and roll party, do cocaine, yeah. I ain't here for that. Anyway, there was a friend of mine who was telling me how some of the members of my family and some of the friends of my family have taken a great offense at what I said in this magazine. It's a shame. Look what he's done to his mother. His mother can't even go out of the house now. It was amazing. My mother could have gone out of the house before knowing the shit she fucking knew. And why is he talking about this? Because it might not have happened to you, but it might have happened to the two or three people that are standing around you who got some fucked up family life that's gonna come back to haunt them when they hit about the age of 25. And then you gotta find your way trying to climb your way out of what you thought was your life, but it looks more in your head like a fucking car wreck that no one told you about. Because the family doesn't want to be embarrassed by these things coming out. We just don't want to have to deal with this, and we shouldn't have to deal with this publicly. But if we don't deal with it publicly, then we're probably not going to deal with the bullshit at all. And I bet they'd like it that way. I'm not a qualified therapist. I don't know a lot of shit about this, but I do know that we're in the 90s. And I do know that if we're gonna make it for another 50 years on this planet, we gotta fucking change our shit now. And there's a lot of motherfuckers that don't want that shit to be changed because that's gonna dig up their crap. There's a lot of parents who done fucked up their kids through their whole fucking lives and they're about 40, they're about 50, and they think it's cool. Fuck that shit. And I'm the last motherfucking person they thought would be climbing up their ass to tell them about it. But see, for me now, it ain't about fucking doing cocaine. It ain't about how much vodka I drink and how much I can drink someone else under the table. It ain't about what a fucking macho man rock and roller I can be. That shit don't work no more. That's great for little kid rock and roll fucking bullshit, but it don't work no more in the real world for my ass. I can't come up here and go, yeah, I'm bad, I'm rock and roll, we're doing this rock and roll thing. If my life is falling apart, I can't fake it no more. And just because my family or my record company or somebody else tells me I should so everybody can be happy and make money and... Yeah, suck my dick. Anyway, there are those in my family who are, they plan now that I've written these things that they're gonna get revenge because it was a terrible thing I did and we're gonna get revenge. Yeah, try it. And if a fucking scrawny little junior high 90 pound weakling can finally get his ass up here and take this shit on, so can any one of you that have the same fucking bullshit problems in your life. They don't have to get away with it. I tried being nice. I tried being cool about it. I tried, like, being friends and offering forgiveness and love and all that kind of shit. All I got was, you know how much we love you, but let's keep the screws on and keep you down like we always have. Yeah, well, guess what? I changed my point of view. For me now, it's kind of like, live and let die, motherfucker. When you were young and your heart was more than blood, you used to say, live and let live.
You know you did, you know you did, you know you did.
But if this ever changing world in which we live in makes you give it a try, then give it a try.
Thank you.